It's October, baby, the month of the demons and the ghouls. And you know, many have wondered, where exactly do these demons and ghouls come from? I mean, all species must have an origin, right? Am I right? And that is precisely what we will be exploring today. Yes, that's right, baby. It's time for Spoorbonnet Season 14. The theme being Spooky Halloween. You know, that kind of rhymed. Anyway, I have gone right ahead and chosen a planet for this season. This planet is perfect. Look at the oceans of blood and the dry lands of death. Yes, it's perfect. It is perfect for the spooky wookie. Spooky wookie. Well, I guess that settles it. I guess Spooky Wookie shall be the name of our species. It spoke to me. It just came to me. So I actually asked you guys what our starter cell should look like. And we got so many great suggestions. Like so many. I wish I could choose them all. But there were a lot of people that wanted to see a pumpkin cell. And I mean a lot of people. There were a lot of people that wanted to see a floating pumpkin. And normally I wouldn't take an idea that's so popular, but man, a pumpkin cell? I mean, it's perfect. It's perfect for the Halloween season. So yes, we shall be starting our season as a pumpkin. But don't you worry. Throughout this season, we shall be testing various types of horror and spookiness. So don't you worry, the pumpkin might not stay for the entire season. But it's a fitting start, guys. Let's get right into making our little pumpkin spice monster. Now, how am I gonna do this? How does one make a pumpkin in Spore? That's not a pumpkin. That's not a pumpkin. I don't know what that is, but I didn't like it. I did not like it. This might come in useful later on. I'm just gonna place it right there. There we go. That's a good spot for it. Just like that. There we go. Yeah, he seems happy about that. Yeah, look at that. He's smiling. He likes that spot. That's a good spot for him. We'll save him for later. But this one is really cool too. I want them all. Okay, hold up. Right here. Right here is a good spot for him. Okay, so I go. Wait a minute. No! Not this bug again! Oh, if you haven't watched my dream series, yeah, this is a bug that has been continuously happening to everything that I create in Spore. I cannot name anything anymore. Everything is just called Justin Timberlake. I hate it! I hate it so much, but fine! Fine, this jack-o'-lantern is now Justin Timberlake. Jack-o'-Timberlake. Alright, so like I was saying, I found a lot of parts that I would want to use later on. Now, these are all parts that I can't actually get from bones, which is why I'm placing them on the creature right now, so that I can actually use them later on. It's not cheating, this is just the only way to actually use them in-game. So yeah, there we go, let's just hide them right there. Alright, so here we have our starter pumpkin. I don't know, man. Oh, man, I hate the fact that cells are transparent, so now I can see all those parts that I was trying to hide. That's not hidden at all. Anyway, here we have our starter cell, but as of right now, he is completely useless. He cannot eat, he cannot see, and he cannot swim. We got no stats. So, let's see here. Jaw. Alright, let's put the jaw right there. Hopefully, can you see it from above? You can't see it from above. Okay, good. Then let's add a couple of eyeballs. Eyeballs are always good. Oh my god, he looks so nasty with eyeballs. Why does he look so nasty with eyeballs? Oh my god, is that better? I'm not sure if that's better. That looks really disgusting, though. Oh, real nasty. Oh, absolutely nasty. Okay. All right, I think I've completely butchered our pumpkin. But it's the only way he will actually work. So excuse me, guys. But this is the only way he will actually work in-game. I hate it. I hate it so much. But there we have it, everybody. Save and exit. Name your planet. Halloweeny. Fortini. Martini. Yes, there we go. Halloween and Fortini Martini is our planet, and it's a beautiful name at that.
Started from the bottom, now we here. Yeah, started as a sail, then we're hot up on my trail. Evolution going well, so I gotta be prevail. Build a city, now you know it's our year.
Oh, and here we go, the start of our adventures. Right here, baby, right here. Yes, yes, the origin of these spooky ghouls and demons. This is it right here. Yes, it came from space. Paranormal Activity just became a science fiction movie. Oh, this planet is perfect. Look at the little things popping out of the ground. Demon spawn, it must be demon spawn. And the oceans of blood. Yes, indeed, it's the perfect breeding ground for our pumpkins. Yes, yes, float into the dark, my precious. We shall soon teach this planet that vegetables kill. Oh, look at eyes. Okay, you know what? This is kind of adorable. Seeing a little pumpkin swimming around like that. I like it. I like it. Hello. I want to taste you.
I'ma taste that booty. I'ma taste that booty. I'm gonna taste that booty.
Ooh, taste the booty. Okay. Oh, I want another bite. I want another bite. Oh, okay. Oh, I just blew him up in smithereens by biting his booty. I must have hit a nerve or something. Oh, everybody's scared of me. Oh, this is great. This is fantastic. This is exactly how it should be. All right. So, the Halloween season. Which brings me to a question I want to ask you guys. You see, I was raised in Iceland. I currently live in Sweden. But in Iceland, we don't celebrate Halloween. What is this? Oh, right. We get a part now. Okay. Like I was saying, in Iceland, we don't celebrate Halloween. So I know very little about Halloween, actually. All I know is movies. Everything that I've seen from movies is all I know. So I want to hear from you guys. What are your Halloween traditions? What do you plan on doing and dressing up as on this Halloween? Do let me know in the comment section down below. I cannot wait to read your comments. Halloween has always intrigued me, especially since I was never allowed to go trick-and-treating as a kid. I did try to start it once in Iceland, though. When I was like 10 years old, I actually dressed up on Halloween. Went out, started knocking on doors, saying trick or treat, and I cannot tell you how many times the door was slammed on my face. I got no candy. That's actually a lie. There was actually one old couple that felt sorry for me and gave me some candy. And what did I do? I went back home, changed costumes, and went right back to that old couple thinking they wouldn't recognize me. I'm just a different kid. They did recognize me, by the way, and they were quite disappointed in me that I even tried that little trick. I didn't get more candy, by the way. You know what? This is actually going quite well, I say, as I'm currently being followed by a big spiktopus. Okay, hold up. I need to call a mate. I need to call a mate right now. Oh, and of course the mate is right behind the little spiky murderer dude. Just let me pass. Just let me pass. There we go. Okay, we need to make our first upgrades to our little pumpkin dude. But first, I'm gonna see if I can actually rename him. I don't wanna be... Yes! Oh, we could rename him. Okay, fantastic. What did I say the species name should be? The Spooky Wookie? Yes, there we go. The Spooky Wookie. All right, there we go. Fantastic. We can now add a couple of spikes to our bad boy. And I think we might. I think we might just do that. I don't know. Maybe there's like some infestation on this pumpkin patch that this guy came from. Made them start growing some horns on the sides. Yeah, very unfortunate. Maybe this is like pumpkin puberty. Yeah, these are the pimples. It happens to everybody. His body is changing. A lot of hormones. Yes, he doesn't like that we bring it up. So let's not talk about it. All right, so we've added these spikes. Now let's add a little bit more speed. Now, do pumpkins have roots? Hold up, I need to Google this. Okay, you know what? I Googled it. I couldn't understand shit, so I'm making up my own rules. Yes, they do have roots. They probably don't. All right, just like that. I don't know. He looks so happy. Look at that. Oh, yes. Swiggling his little arms. Swiggle, swiggle. All right, okay. Two roots are not gonna cut it. He needs more roots. He needs to be more rooted. All right, there we go. Super nasty, super disgusting. I love it. Spooky Wookie, let's go for a swim. Okay, there we go. We should have speed now. We should have absolute superior speed. Okay, it's getting faster. It's getting faster. I like it. Now, one thing I maybe should have added was a herbivore mouth just so that we can get this cell stage over quicker. Look at all that food that just drifted by that I cannot eat. Ah, fine. I will eat you. Come here. Come here. Oh, all this food. All this food I cannot eat. Oh, well, I could eat you. Well, thank you. Oh, you're enjoying that food now, are you? Mmm, real tasty, isn't it? Yes, here's my plan. I will let him eat that stuff, and then I eat him. That way, I also eat the stuff. Very smart of me, huh? Mmm, yes, very good stuff. Oh, we got the wing dudes. I want the wings. I want all the parts. Thank you. You know what I realized? We haven't died a single time during this cell stage, and that's something that I do not want to ruin. Okay, big guy. Okay, let's go the other direction. I don't like that direction. Oh, poison. Oh, I want the poison, but I just said that I don't want to die. Oh, okay, that's bad. Oh, okay, he's damaged. He only needs one more hit, and then he's dead. Will we be able to do this? Come on. Yes. Oh, part, and then go. Part and go. Okay, we did it. We got the poison. We got the poison, baby. Super simple, too. This is going fantastically. Oh, super big dude. Okay, you know what? Getting killed. Oh, stop. I was in the middle of talking. Getting kills is starting to get a lot harder by every stage we progress. So that is exactly why we shall be doing a little bit of upgrading. Let's see here. We got a few more parts. Yes, we have the poison and we have these things. All right, I guess I could add the wing thingies. It could be a little leaf right there. Yes, it's a beautiful leaf. Very nice. But most importantly, what we are after is this. The poison. The spit poison. Okay. Yes, we are going to be a rotten little pumpkin poisoning the ocean. Yes. It's October, baby. This month, we don't care about the environment. No, if the ghouls and demons don't care, then we don't care. There we go, baby. Oh, there we go. 5 in poison. Now, this should definitely do some damage. Okay, spooky wookie, let's go. Okay, let's see that purple cloud of mine. Yes, this should be enough poison. Okay, I'm just gonna swim in circles around this guy, and it worked. That's all I need to do. I just need to fly in circles around somebody, and boom, we got him. Okay, who's my next victim? You there. I see your orange. Yeah, you see, I have already filed a trademark on the orange color this season, so I'm afraid you must die. Yes, that is the penalty of breaching that trademark agreement. Okay, this is not working out so well. He just keeps on swimming in circles, too. Okay, I need to start making the circle a little bit smaller. Oh, you know what? I could just do this. Okay, that was a lot easier. I didn't need to swim in circles around it forever. Ooh, you! I don't have you yet. Okay, thank you. Oh, and there we go. I believe we are now officially collected all the parts. Oh, there's another me. Another spooky wookie. Okay. He didn't want to stop and say hi. We're not a social bunch. Whoa, look at all the death and destruction I leave behind. If I'm just swimming around, everybody gets caught up in my poison, which was exactly my plan. You see? Look at all this food. Man, are we actually going to do it? Are we really going to finish the cell stage without dying? That might not sound like such an achievement for most of you, but for me, I don't think I've ever done that. I think I've always died at least once. But it seems like this might be the day. Oh, stop it. Leave me alone. I am so scared. Okay. I thought I was a goner for sure. Eat these eggs. There we go. Yes, baby, there we have it. We got a little brainiosis, meaning that we did finish the cell stage without dying. Congratulations, you are on the path to sentience. Woohoo, okay, baby. Advanced to creature stage, baby. Oh, wow, we got a carnivore trait. I would have never have guessed. And it only took us 2,300,000,000 years. Well, there we have it. Okay, well, let's go put some legs on this bad boy. Oh, man, okay, you little nasty. All right, let's get rid of most of these parts. Okay, so the parts that I previously put aside for us to use later, let me go over them real quick. Yes, this is very important. So here are all the parts that I put aside before. We got a really creepy human face. We have a human skull. We have some type of an animal skull action. Goat, maybe? I don't know. We have chains that we can fully customize. And then we have 3 sets of different colors that we can use. Those colors being red for blood, the black for maybe a black cloak, and white for maybe some bony material. So here's my question for today. What would you want me to create in the next episode using these parts? At least some of them. Of course, we're not going to be using all of these heads, at least not all at once. So yeah, take a look at all of these parts. Take a real good look and think, what would be the perfect use of these parts? Now, of course, we will also have other parts available to us. But using these parts, what would you want me to create in the next episode? do let me know in the comment section down below, and I'll be sure to read them before the next episode. But for today, we shall not be bothering with these parts. No, that comes next episode. So let's just place them all back there. There we go. And hidden. Fantastic. Okay, back to the pumpkin. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, I don't believe the pumpkins have anything underneath them. So wouldn't this make more sense? I mean, it looks horrible, but it would make more sense if I'm not mistaken. Looks really weird. Yeah, so something like that would probably make more sense. But is it the better option? I don't think so. Sometimes, even if it makes more sense, doesn't make it the better option. See, just like that, that's way better. Okay, so I'm gonna mess around with this little pumpkin dude for a little bit, and we'll see what I can come up with. All right, I'll see you in a second. So there we have our little spooky wookie pumpkin jack-o'-lantern. That's a long name. I need to figure out a better name. Oh, and if you're wondering about these white orbs above his eyes, they will not show up in the actual game. That's just so that I can move around the little light thing in his eyes. So don't you worry. That's not a part of the aesthetics. So yeah, what do you think? I tried to make his legs really rooty, if that makes sense. And I honestly think he is adorable, which means I failed. I failed miserably because he's not supposed to be adorable. This is the spooky wookie. He's supposed to be spooky. But fine. Okay, this can be like a rags to riches story. Okay, he starts out all cute and fuzzy little pumpkin character. But don't you worry. Oh, he's gonna evolve. Oh, he's going to represent everything bad in this universe. Yes. Yes, yes, even TikTok. He's even supposed to represent the evil of TikTok. Anyway, Spooky Wookie, I believe you are ready. Oh, wait, no, wait. That was close. One thing we do need to add. Eyes. We need eyes. Of course we need... Oh, my God, he's so adorable. No. You know, now he's not as adorable. Okay, this could work. Just like these really, really small eyes right inside of the glow right there. Oh, that's nasty. Super nasty. Oh, yeah. Very, very super nasty. Fantastic. Okay, Spooky Wookie, you are ready. Save and exit. Oh, and here he comes. Climbing out of the oceans of blood. Looking around, seeing his competition. Oh, he feels confident. Confident enough to call his friends up above the land. Yes, it is time. It is time. For the pumpkin revolution. Oh, you know what? They look so adorable. No, they don't look adorable. They are Scary Berry. Oh, you know what? Scary Berry is also a very cool name. Yeah. Okay. It is the beginning of a new day, and for you, a whole new strange and wondrous world. Air fills your lungs as you stretch into your limbs in your new home. Dry land. The race to evolve has begun. Okay, baby. Yes. Very beautiful. Oh, and this planet really is perfect. I told you guys. Isn't this just the most perfect color scheme for these little dudes? Speaking of these little dudes, you know what? I don't mind them. I don't mind them one bit. Look at their nasty little legs. The little rooted nasty legs. Yes, give me a little twirl. Give me a little twirl. Fantastic. Okay. So yeah, there we have it. What do you guys think of the theme for this season? And do let me know all of your ideas, your tips, your suggestions on what we shall be creating in the next episode. And you know what? I am really happy with this little pumpkin guy. I believe it's a great start. It's a beautiful start indeed. Alright guys, so I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode of Spore Modded. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you did, and I will see all of you beautiful Halloween lovers in the next episode. Have a good one, guys.